There it is. Should we step in at the same time?
You ready?
All the tradition in this place and in this floor. And one thing I'm thinking of is how long the Opry's been around. It's been like an oak tree to America, just kind of always has been, and it's still here. And to be a small part of the story is just breathtaking. I'm trying to hold back the tears.
You only get to do a few truly spectacular things in your life, you know, if you're blessed, and it's pretty cool to get to do this with you, man.
I've never seen a show here. I've been in this building, but I've never been to the Opry show because I wanted the first time to be on the front row right here. So people tell you about what it's gonna feel like, and somebody told us it's like a grandma giving you a big old hug.
Yeah, that's right.
Well, I am a man of constant sorrow.
Brent and I met, it's been like 15, 16 years ago, back in our hometown. We, in Kentucky, I feel like you always gotta say the county, Bullitt County, Kentucky. And he was in a different band, I was in a different band, and we started writing songs together, and it was just kind of magic right there in that moment, from the beginning, you know?
And we got to a point where it was like, are we gonna do this for real or not? So we both moved to Nashville together, and we were roommates for like 7 years or something, and then we both got married and had kids, and now we're responsible.
Coming up with band names is harder. It was harder to come up with a band name than to find the name for mine and my wife's first son.
In the studio, recording our first round of material, we wore out, and so we decided to take a break and put on a movie. As we were watching this movie that we used to watch in college way too much because we only had 4 or 5 movies and no cable because we couldn't afford it. Right there, George Clooney's character on Old Brother Where Art Thou is Ulysses Everett McGill. They went through a heck of a journey to become the Soggy Bottom Boys. Well, we could relate, you know, and so here we are, we're Everett. It was an early age for me, you know. I grew up listening to country music, and I think about my papaw, who's 90 years old. He was gonna come tonight, but he wasn't able to make it. And I just think about, he was telling me that they would tune into the radio. That was the entertainment. You know, they would sit around the radio and listen to the Grand Ole Opry. And
Grand Ole Opry, for me, I just feel like it's a great symbol of, like, togetherness, family, friendship, acceptance.
I hope our songs leave an imprint on the hearts of the people out there. You know, and they, you know, the music is powerful. You know, if something moves them or something makes you feel something, that doesn't just stay here in the Opry House. That spreads once people walk out the door. Mm-hmm. So I hope the music connects the way we hope it will. And I also, I'd be lying if I didn't say I want to make these people that I see here on these posters and stuff proud.
I'll meet you on God's golden shore. He'll meet you on God's golden shore.
So we just got done with our Grand Ole Opry debut performance, and my voice is a little shaky because I'm
still kind of catching my breath.
Yeah, man. That was everything I hoped it would be and more. I mean, the
very end, the announcer, yes, ladies and gentlemen, that is a standing ovation you hear. And I looked up, and everybody's standing up. I'm just kind of like, oh God, here comes the tears.
Very first time on the Grand Ole Opry stage, ladies and gentlemen, Everette.